Hey, it's Coach Jamila, and for those of you that don't know, I'm a transformation life coach. And what that means is that I help women heal their self-worth, their self-confidence, their self-esteem, so that they are able to be happy. So in short, I teach women how to be happy. So in harmony with that, the question I'm answering today is, what does humility have to do with happiness? Now, many people associate the word humble or humility with being a doormat, or not being assertive, or putting up with deal-breaking inappropriate behaviors. And that's not what it means at all, to be humble or to show humility. It actually means to be teachable. Because the fact of the matter is, if you think you already know it all, or that you already have all the answers, then how can you grow? If you're not willing to consider that you are wrong, or that you don't know everything, then how can you be open to new information, new ideas, new concepts, new thinking, and grow? Okay? Now, another way that humility is linked to our happiness is that if we can't accept that sometimes things are not going to go our way, of course, because the world does not revolve around us, if we can't accept that and figure out how to cope with those challenges when they arise, then we're gonna find it very difficult to be happy. We're always gonna be in a state of struggling to feel good, because we're always gonna feel like we're being attacked or like something's going wrong in our life, when the reality is, life is full of challenges, but it's our reaction to it. It's how the attitude we show towards it that really determines whether or not we're going to maintain our peace and our happiness, okay? Now, also, when we're humble, we take responsibility for our actions and our part in any situation. So when we're humble, we don't blame others or constantly look outside ourselves for the reason as to why things are going wrong or not going our way. We look inward and we ask, what could I have done better? What can I learn from this? How can I use this as an opportunity to grow and become a better person? So that's what humility allows you to do. Now, if you are humble enough to admit that you don't have all the answers when it comes to trying to figure out how to get out of your own way, how to stop being a browbeater, where if you're a woman who browbeats yourself, and by that I mean you're constantly saying, I need to do this, I need to do that, you need to do this, get up, do this, you need to lose weight. You know, you're just always browbeating yourself into and driving yourself like a horse or some farm animal for every single thing that you do in your life, and you never show yourself any sort of compassion or grace or peace or any of that. You're just constantly on your own back. If that's something that you struggle with, if you struggle with feeling a lack of confidence, you maybe get mistreated by your boss at work, you maybe get taken advantage of by everyone in your life, and you feel like your feelings are always stomped on, or if you feel like you're a people pleaser, all you care about and worry about is what everyone else thinks of you and whether or not people like you. If any of these are challenges or struggles or things that you're dealing with, then finding happiness is going to be a challenge. And if that's the case, then I want to share something with you. I have an 8-week boot camp. It's called Get Real and Heal. It's my Get Real and Heal Confidence and Happiness Boot Camp. It's 8 weeks where we address self-esteem, self-worth, self-sabotaging tendencies, and really get to the bottom of all of these issues and work to correct them. Now, if that sounds like something that you would love to experience, to be free of all that and to have the opportunity to go through it with like-minded women who understand what you're going through, then by all means, apply to join the boot camp by booking a free 30-minute discovery and action call with me today. I will put the details below. And anyway, thank you for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, or follow, depending on which social media platform you're watching this on. And I look forward to seeing you here as you watch future videos.